Hello friends, welcome to my YouTube channel. Today we will learn about how we can use for next loop at a time in 2 to 3 sheets. In the last previous two videos, we are just discussed about the basics of for next loop. If you have not watched those videos, then you can click on the I button being displayed on the right side corner of the video. This is the worksheet that I have opened. This is the developer tab. If this tab is not displaying on your Excel sheet, then click on file menu, then click on options, then click on customize ribbon. Here is an option, developer tab, which has been tick marked. If this is not tick marked, then tick mark it, then click on OK button. In this process, developer tab will get activated on your Excel sheet. And now we'll open the Visual Basic window. You can press Alt F11 on the keyboard, or you can go to developer tab, click here, and you can see here Visual Basic. You can also click here for opening the Visual Basic window. This is the interface of the Visual Basic window. Here we'll click on Insert menu. This is the insert menu. Click here, we'll take a module. Here, module 1, you can rename it. For loop 01, press enter. Here I will write the sub procedure and code. First sub procedure, subroutine sub for loop _ example, press enter. First of all, I will declare variables dim I as integer, dim k as integer, dim c as integer. So friends, I'll pressing the windows side by side. I will also take a local window. Go to view menu. This is the view menu. Click here and local window. So you can see here on the local window how the codes are being executed. First of all, for I equal to 1, 2, 3, instead of I have written here 1, I equal to 1, 2, 3, next I, then for k equal to 1, 2, 2, next k, then c equal to, for c equal to 1, 2, 2. We'll print two sheets, worksheet 1 and sheet 2. Let's write the code. Worksheet sheets c bracket close dot cells rows 1 column rows I column k dot value equal to, I will take your 5000. Let's check the code, how whether it is right or not. You can press F8 on the keyboard, or you can see here step information. Click here, something went wrong. Next k, yes, I have forgotten to write close to write next c here. Next c, so this is the coding part. I am I'm resetting it, then we'll check it again. Click on F8 on the keyboard, or you can click here step information. You can also see here on the local window, you can see here I equal to 1, then K equal to 1, then C equal to 1. Now it will execute the code and enter the value of 5000 into the cell at the intersection of row 1 and column 1. Let's see, click on F8. You can see the amount has been printed into the cell at the intersection of row 1 and column 1. Again it will execute the code, then it will print 5000 on the sheet 2 at the intersection of row 1 and column 1. Then again it will come back and enter the value 5000 into the cell at the intersection of row 1 and column 2. See how it works. You can see 5000 has been printed in column 2 and row 1. Then it will go to next sheet. See, this is the result. This has also been printed into the cell at the intersection of row 1 and column 1. Now it will come back again and go to next row. Since we have taken 3 rows here, it will go to next I. Click here, F8. This is the next 8, then it will come back to for case statement. Then again it will print 5000 into the cell at the intersection of row 2 and column 1. See how it works. You can see here 5000 has been printed in row 2, column 1. Then it will go to sheet 2. This is the sheet 2. Then it will also print the value into the cell here. The value has been printed. Then it will come back again and print the value 5000 in the column 2. So now it will come back to row. You can see here it will drive. Come to the C next I, then it will go to case statement. For case statement, it will check another one row is left to be filled up. Then it will execute. We will repeat the same tax here. 5000 has been printed. Then it will go back again to the code execution. Then it will print the 5000 in the sheet 2. Click here. In this way, 3 rows. We have taken 3 rows. 3 rows. 3 row numbers have been printed in 3 rows and 2 columns. Then it will come out of the loop. You can see it will come out of the loop. So in this way, for next loop works in sheets also. Take another way, if we just increase one sheet, suppose 3, then how it will work. Let's see. I'm deleting these numbers sheet from sheet 1 and sheet 2. As said earlier, the same process will be repeated again and again till the condition is met, because we have taken 3 sheets, 2 columns and 3 sheets. First it will print on 3 sheets, sheet 1, sheet 2, sheet 3. Press F8 on the keyboard. Here you can see I equal to 1, K equal to 1, C equal to 1. Now it will print the value 5000 into the cell at the intersection of row 1 and column 1 first. Click F8. You can see here 5000 has been printed on sheet 1. The same process will be repeated in this sheet 2. You can see here in the sheet 2 and again you can also see the same thing in the sheet 2. Next come to the sheet 1, it will again print the value in column B. You can see here, you can also see here on the local window. Local window, you can see here, same thing is being repeated time and again till it comes to row 3. Now it will come out of the, whether it has been printed now, yes, all those have been printed, then it will come out of the loop. In this way for loop works. First of all, I am deleting these all numbers. We'll take a shape. Insert a shape. This is shape. I'll take a shape. This is the name of our loop, for loop example. Right click on it. Assign macro. Click OK. Click here. Then double click on for loop. You can see whether it is, yes, for loop example. Okay, now you can rename it. Click, suppose I will clean right here, click. Now just click on the button. You can see here 5005 has been printed. The numbers have been printed in the sheet 3. The same numbers have been printed on sheet 2, and the same numbers have been also printed in sheet 3. Once more I will click on click button. You can see here the how the numbers have been printed on the each sheet. This is sheet 3, this is sheet 2, and this is sheet 1. In this way for loop works in Excel VBA. Thank you very much friends for watching this video. If you like this video, don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Thank you very much.